What's up, y'all? Welcome to video number 485 or so, make it Songbringer. Today I'm converting this area into the bridge of Songbringer. So there'll be a captain, there'll be like captain's chair, there'll be like consoles, blinking lights, windows, all that kind of stuff. It's gonna be an important character in the game too, the captain. So, without further ado, Sound Dogs, what's up, man? Pizza Man for Captain? You want a Pizza Man to be Captain? That's a good idea. Okay, well, where to start? There's lots to do here. I think the first thing I want to do is have some windows. So that means that the area that I'm currently in here is going to need to convert all of its sky tiles. So all these sky tiles, these pits right here, are actually sky tiles. So I'll need to kind of like round off this. So there's some walls right here on these edges. And then walls will totally encircle most of this, except for where the windows are going to be. Okay, so let's get it started. First of all, this area, need to take away make those sky tiles come to a point, basically, so. Area patterns. Pattern. What pattern is that? Pattern ship. Yeah, pattern ship. Smith. Teleport. Stage. Not the stage. Hangar. Is it observation or hangar? Oh, it's currently called stage. It's called stage. Well, whatever. Let's fix this other one here. Teleport. This one's the middle. Teleport. Light sconces, light pillars. Okay, so if width. No. If X is less than 2, block set K tile wall. Let's put some walls on the left there. Salad Dongs, what you doing, man? How's the engine coming? Whoops. I kind of broke everything. Lol. Oh, not return. Continue. Ship it. How's school going? There's plenty of room. Oh, here we go. Yeah. Block it off, man. We don't need to go there. What's the Y path? Why? Actually, I think I think that'll work. There we go. Okay, we got walls there. Good. Now we can shape this room. Call it something a little more descriptive, eh? As for the engine, you got a new laptop? All right, man. Cool. Port into Windows. That's awesome. So you'll be dual platform. That's badass. You're gonna wait? Nice, yeah. I think it's a good idea. Do it now, you'll have it kind of. You'll at least have the basis for both platforms. Pattern, ship, stage. The stage is going to be actually on the overworld. They're going to go down to the overworld and set up a stage there. So this will be called this pattern ship bridge. All right, cool. We got that. It's compiling. Okay, now the pattern ship bridge. Okay, all y'all NPCs, you're gonna be elsewhere, chitting and chatting. Everything here is gonna be walls. Now we should be all set up. Good way to separate out the platform independent parts of the code anyway. Yeah, you'll have that all layered out. A lot of platform specific code mixed in. Oh yeah. Awesome, man. Yeah, you'll have that modularized, decoupled, cohesive. I'm excited for you, man. I'm so excited. Honestly, you got me kind of inspired to make my own game engine for the next game. Not that I can do it for this one, but I would love to have my own engine. School's going fine? You're finally getting to Java. All right. Stepping up to Java. Okay, cool. We got that. Want to make the tiles below this also. Just powerful looking cup. It's got this like reflection of this long big thing, it makes it look like it's its own power. Okay, so a couple things. The bottom bits down there. Different here. Okay, I think, the next thing to do is start working on the sky tiles and making it look like windows. Eunice, you're pondering the replayability? Yeah. Yeah, man, shoot. Definitely. All right, so if it's, if the X is like less than, all right. On new game pluses, the player gains the ability to face an alternative last boss. Or maybe they'd have to defeat it some other way. That's interesting. End result is after this, instead of the run finishing, they could continue instead and unlock alternative dungeons. New path is opened up. Rock has to use either use the cup, meditate a certain spot, or even go into a cryo chamber in order to access these new dungeons. And they're regenerated based on the value of one world seed over. And have their palettes change up so they're more spiritual. The enemies are altered to be much more aggressive and challenging. I like it. Each dungeon represents an aspect of Rock and gets you familiarized more with who he is, what he's like, his fears, wants, worries. Nice. Adding scenes where you have to hack in a computer in a hurry. But Rock has no idea what he's doing. So we toss the potato in. Yeah, it definitely would. That's awesome. That's a really great idea. So I have already been meaning to like share more of Rock's character, who he is, where he comes from, his past, how he got to be part owner of Songbringer, how he met, you know, Jib and all that. So that would be a good way to share that. And I've always wanted to have more dungeons and bosses too. I like that. I like that, Venus. Thank you for sharing that. I'm gonna kind of like let that simmer, and something will come of that, I'm sure. Potato strikes again. Oh my god, that potato bug was so easy. Once I figured out what was going on, I'm like, oh my god, this is so stupid. So potato, that whole issue with potato. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Was just the my assert method. So in my assert method, I was throwing, and basically in debug mode is the only place where it catches the throw, because, well, in release mode it also catches the throw, but in release mode it doesn't count that as an error because it's has to proceed somehow, right? It doesn't just exit the game. So in if it ever asserts, the proper thing to do is exit. You know, log out the message and then exit immediately so you know there's an issue that's debug only. Otherwise, you're in this situation where debug mode is different than release mode. So all that was happening with Potato World Seed was just it was throwing. It was throwing an error, and it was allowing that error. It was just logging that error out, but then allowing it to generate another world. So what are templates? Well, there's templated classes, and there's also templated functions. So if X is like less than, let's just start with W2. We're gonna make these windows. Okay. All right, so for now I'm going to move the cup. The couple we're going to put elsewhere. See if that works. Nice, man. What's he, so what is a handmade hero doing right now? What are you learning from it? Standard vector is temp. Oh yeah, yeah. Oops, they put the cup in up there, which is weird. It's probably the create items function. Let's just take this off. If we have an item on the ship, it will just always start like there. Manually setting up a Win32 window. Wow, dude, that's awesome. I bet you that's so informative. Especially where you're at, Rocket Bunny. Learning to make your own engines and stuff. Also, kind of a weird place for that. I guess this was kind of necessary. Let's do ship bridge and ship hangar. That's a positive two. Maybe that's negative two there. A little bit more. Negative four. Nice, Emacs. Okay, good enough. So now we're back here. The next thing I want to do is take all these tiles out here and turn this into windows. So you're looking out. Okay. So create sky tile. Really, it's just needs to be so no sky tiles are just invisible. Invisible. Invisible sky tiles. If pattern equals K pattern ship bridge return. So that should just do black. And then we're gonna make a special sky. Or maybe we'll do clouds. Oh, that's right, we're using this kind of ground. Shoot. two choices here. One choice, I could take the ground and split it up into separate tiles. So for every tile that is actually going to be a ground tile, I could do a special slice of the overall ground texture. The other choice is I could try and put the sky on top, but that's not going to work very well if I want to do because if I want to do clouds, then the clouds are kind of fuzzy and stuff like that, so you're not going to be able to, it's going to suck. Okay, so that idea is out. Okay, so that leaves either slicing them up into a bunch of different tiles or making a special texture where it cuts out all of the sky tiles. Cutting out and making a whole special texture. For some reason, I don't like that idea. Okay, I'll go with the other way. That's where I'm going to make individual slices of the ground texture. All right, let's do this. What's up, Farpoke? So anyways, before I do this, this is going to take a minute to code. So I'm just going to take a little screenshot. What's up today? I'm making the bridge. So this is going to be a cap. There's going to be a captain here, a new NPC. His name is Garth Waite Tusk. He's half dropped, or rumored to be half dropped, because he's going to be huge. There's going to be like a captain's chair, like blinking consoles, lights, windows, and it's going to look out on the sky where Songbringer is just sitting in the atmosphere and all that. So that's cool. Oh, check this out. You can change when you change your language, it changes your HUD text. So it says, I don't know how to say that in Portuguese. Corajim? Coragio. I kind of like Swedish. Yeah, so the technique I'm going to use here, so the problem that I have here is I've got this big old ground texture, and all these red tiles out here, I want to be windows. So you're looking out onto the sky, outside of the ship. Which means that I need to change up the way this ground texture works so that it's not drawing the ground texture out here, so that I can draw sky and clouds and fog and all that other kind of goodness. So that means I need to make this ground texture a little smarter. Okay, so. Oh yeah, let's take a screenshot. So this is gonna take a minute, but it'll be worth it. So there, I've got a screenshot to refer to. All right. There's gonna need to be a new kind of ground style. There's like, this is image one, but it's more like image two, where it's rendering the whole image in pieces. Zeith, what's up, man? How you been, Zeith? It's been a while since I've seen your name. Okay, so we got. I'm just looking at the places where it references ground image one. Actually, let's start compiling it. So there'll be image one and image two. Image two slices up the image into a bunch of different tiles. You been good? Nice. Good to hear. Area creation tile based sky. Oh, now we've got a much better way to do this. So we don't even need to do this whole thing right here because we're going to make this particular area here. Let's do this now before I forget. World CPP. Where is there a little flag or whatever for ground style? There's not. Oh, this is Maisy. It is Maisy. So Maisy has choose styles. That's where we want it. Okay, so choose styles, ground style. There's just one exception here. If pattern is K pattern. Ship bridge ground style equals K ground image 2. So we'll slice up the image. Let's check on these other references here. Anim sync. Yeah, this is not that important, but yeah, in fact. Nothing is really going to sink inside the bridge, so I'm not even going to worry about changing this here. All right, we're going to have a function for this. Ground image, or image to ground. What's this one? Oh, this is creating an item. Okay. So if it's creating an item and it's a hidden item, okay, there's going to be no hidden items here either. So I'm not going to worry about that either. Cool. Okay. So we've got things partially set up. Now, I just noticed that I don't want these functions here. Where are these at? Create image one ground. All these, they don't need to be in the header file. My style has changed a little bit over the years of coding Songbringer, and I much prefer to not put things inside a header file if I don't have to. These functions, I don't have to. They're only used in one place, inside area CPP. So there's no need to put them in the header. Let's take all these out. Sky 1, Sky 2, Fog 1, all these. We'll just define them statically. Change these maps. Change these to statics. So this is a much easier on the compiler. It's less lines in the header. And not much easier on the compiler, but it's easier on the compiler because it doesn't have as much stuff to put in the header. It's less things to process. If you need, if some other file needs area.h, it doesn't need to worry about the fact that area.h has some or area.cpp has some private function called create sky one background. Anyways, man, I wish I was a smarter programmer when I started this whole project. Oh, and all these functions will need access to the area. Okay, so we change these up a little bit. All these will take an area ref. Make sure it's still working. Colors is private. Autocomplete. Jeez. What's up, HD? Yo. Welcome to today, man. How you doing today? Wait, what did I do wrong here? What? Colors? Oh, this is watercolor. Let's just simplify. Glad to be here. Right on. All is very well, yes. I got some cool new story elements created starting today. And now I'm working on this. I'm working on this, the bridge. So this is the bridge of Songbringer, where there's going to be a captain's chair, a captain, like consoles, windows, and everything. So that's what I'm working on right now, these window bits. This is all going to be sky and windows looking out. So I'm working on making it so this ground texture can be all sliced up so that part of it won't draw. So there can be some sky. Yeah. This is kind of a cool moment because it's been a long time where I've always wanted to make Songbringer cooler, the ship, when you teleport to it and stuff. Now that moment is becoming a reality. Or that moment is here. The moment is now. These all rely on this get water function. How about you, Ichini? What you do? What you working on today, man? What's new? A dot. A dot. A dot. Static void, create fog one background. This one also takes an area ref. I wonder if this is a private function. I can't remember. It is. All right. Whatever. Data equals world get data. Data? What do you guys say? Glad to hear it. Thank you, man. You're getting copy day one? Sweet. You're working on a project too, a Metroidvania? Sweet. Nice. Is it more Metroid or is it more Vania? You say data. I like how you didn't specify whether it's data or data. Data. People bubble. Nice. You're totally wrong. You guys are killing it. Killing it today. Oh. This is a dot area pause. Oh, like both? With Zelda 2? Nice, a fantasy Metroid. Oh, man. Awesome. Jeez. I can't wait to play it, see it. Are you sharing any pictures of it yet? Watercolor, watercolor, A dot tile counts. I need to make that public. I can't remember if that's public or private. Tile counts private. Doesn't like that. Well, let's make a function. You do? Oh, please share. I would love to see. Yeah. Tile count. So we'll make a public function called get tile count. Yes, oh, please, post in the chat. Yeah, absolutely. Everyone is always allowed to post in the chat here. Don't even need to ask. Yeah, the only people that are not allowed to post in the chat are bots. So if you're a human, go right ahead. If you're a human pretending to be a robot, go right ahead. If you're a robot pretending to be a human, you're not allowed. You hear that? Robots pretending to be humans? Don't even try. Tile count. All right, so we just return tile counts. Tile. That was hard. You feel discriminated against? What if my AI reaches a sufficient level? May I post then? No! Never! Joking. If you write an AI, that convinces us that it's human, go right ahead. But it better be polite about it. Oh, it's map tile type int. What? What's wrong with this? Turing test passed. Yeah, man, if it's polite, it's Turing test passed. Hey, cool, man. Right on, I like this style. Awesome. Looking forward to seeing some more. Oh, sweet, some more. Yeah, so what character are you? The green? The green character? What about when the singularity event starts and we slowly become cybernetic? Will I draw the line on that? Definitely. Yep, the line is already drawn. When we start becoming more cybernetic, no one can ever post again. Not allowed. Sorry, no more chatting. Ooh, I like this one a lot. This is cool. This has a really Zelda 2 vibe to it right here. Awesome, man. You're down, make me a robot. What the hell is wrong with this function? Tile type. Oh, I guess it would modify the array if it doesn't exist. Oh man, that's not very clear. Tile counts, stop find, tile. If it is not equal to tile counts, dot end. Narrow implant, artificial limbs. What about pacemakers? Pacemakers are all right. Pacemakers aren't going to take over the universe or anything. Whoa, I like this too, man. I agree with Salad Dongs here, though. If you just made the background a little bit darker, it would really help the foreground pop out a little bit. But I love this art style, dude. You got something really unique here. That's awesome. Cool. Return it. Return k tile none. Now it doesn't modify tile counts ever. Oh, return it second. Boogie, what's up, man? I'll write a sci-fi novel about a race of sentient pacemakers. We control your hearts. We control the world. Yeah, absolutely, Ichi. Anybody else that's wondering, hey, can I post here? Yeah, you can. As long as you're not a robot. Or a sentient pacemaker. Image 2 ground, coming up. We'll have that here in a second. Tile counts. This is going to become a.get tile count. Oh, Boogie. By the way, here's what I'm working on. I'm working on changing this room here on Songbringer to be the bridge. So there's going to be a captain, captain's chair, consoles, blinking lights, windows, stuff like that. The party room and all the crazy NPCs are actually going to be on the overworld now. There's going to be a ship, a tiny like away ship that goes down to the planet's surface that has speakers on it, and that's where the party's going to be. So all those people are like dressed up and stuff, and they're dancing. So this is going to be more of like the ship. This is where the bridge is. Yeah, this is the current cup room. So the cup will also move to elsewhere. I'm pretty sure the cup will also be where the people are partying. So, yeah. So I'm working on, right now I'm writing some code that makes it so this big old ground texture can be sliced up, cut up, so that there can be sky here where this red is, and then this is going to be just the texture, the ground texture that's there. So going to take a minute to code that. A.getTileCount, ktiles, skybridge rise, skycount, A.areaPause. A.eddies. Older games better interact items differently. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's true. Games these days aren't using as much like black pixel edges on things, which I find to be awesome. I don't like it. I don't like that style of pixel art as much, where everything has a single black pixel edge. It's like almost cartoony. Which is not bad. I love cartoons. I love video games. I love pixel art. It's just that I think that whole single pixel border thing is, I don't know. What are you guys' thoughts? You like the single pixel border, or do you hate the single pixel border? Should we do a straw poll? It's hard to pull it off well. That's true. There are some really well done ones where you're like, oh, that fits. That looks good. A.area size. Mario. Mario does it good too. I guess I just really love the whole sword and sorcery did it really well, where there was no black pixel outlines. I'm like, look at this. This is beautiful. Wow. Yeah, it is pretty style dependent, huh? World get data a.areaPause.z data.getChild bleep bloop blop bloop. Let's create. Tell me create ground texture is not a private. Oh, yeah, that's an opinion, too. I like that. 16-bit, it works. 8-bit doesn't. Oh, here it is. Create ground texture. Is this public? Private. Hold on. Create ground texture. Does that need to be? No, it doesn't. Doesn't need to be in this header. Entirely case by case. Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. By the Woo? What's by the Woo? By the Woo. Oh, by the way. By the way, Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. Oh. Look at me being all literal. Wind Waker? I like Wind Waker. You're right. It had that whole that what what's that cartoon edge or what's that called when it does the cartoony 3D? I like Wind Waker. I thought it was cool. You could sail everywhere and stuff. It was kind of an interesting take on Zelda. Cell shaded. Right. Yeah. It works really well with Zelda because Zelda's got that whole like you're a boy. You're like a boy that's under the age of 10 style feeling. It got a lot of hate, did it? Great ground texture, A. Hey. Well, this is just create ground texture. Oh man, now we gotta create rocks, pathways, shapes, lily pads. And now people praise it. What fickle creatures we are. Okay, create rocks. Hold on. Well, this rabbit hole is getting kind of deep here, but I swear we're gonna make it through this. Rocks, pathways, grass, plant, shapes, lily pads. Pretty sure we don't need any of this. Shoot, none of this. None of this needs to be in here. This is all private. This is the Zelda Nintendo needs to make. Tell me it's Wand of Gamelon. Totally, look at that. It's gorgeous. Dang, this is just fan art. It's so funny how like sometimes fans create better stuff than Nintendo does. And then Nintendo's like DCMA. Seriously, that's ridiculous. Look at that shimmeriness and everything. Is this a fan game for real? This is amazing. Twenty to 30. Awesome. Like who made that? Right? Who took the time to make that? Because Nintendo's not going to use it, and if he ever releases it, or if she ever releases it, or they ever release it, they're just going to get slammed with a lawsuit or something. Oh wait, create rocks, pathways, shapes, lily pads, all these things. Oh man, This started off as something kind of short and quick and easy, and now it's becoming a long thing. I kind of got sidetracked. Yes, C&D notice near you. Right? Like the Pokemon game that took like 9 years for some fans to make, and it was awesome. Okay, so I'm kind of refactoring some code. Didn't really need to do all this, but I started it, so I'm gonna finish it. Look at me. Carrying on. The Chrono Trigger 3D. I know, Chrono Trigger. Chrono Trigger, man. Why haven't they done more Chrono Trigger? Did you guys see that game theory about Chrono Trigger and like how awesome it was and how Square hasn't done anything with it in like 10 years? But where's the first declaration? Oh, oops. That was supposed to be static. You won't buy Switch because of Nintendo? Yeah. Yeah, Modern Square. The game was very much the case of having a dream team of talent. I think. Oh, is it the team? Could be the team. They just can't get that team back together. We're getting the band back together. We're not getting the band back together. Just refactoring. Refactoring. Totally unnecessary. Duh, 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 duh. Terrain. Terrain needs to be a public. Oh, now I'm using A and B. Guess it could be an I. 8 on terrain. Let's convert these A's to I's. Interesting hypothetical theory. Future copyright laws will incorporate intellectual rights to consumers, since the media can have a greater collective impact on them than the 1 in 100 guys that put it out. Interesting. Replicators are permitted if they are proven to not impact the original works or creator measurable numeric. That's an interesting take. Huh. What a different world it would be with that. That's cool. This is going to become a.getColor, it second. Puffo, he's here. My current version is 1.0.6126.23719. Isn't it? Color type. Does this have a num? Yeah, num color types. Is less than K num color types. Unnecessary, but in the long term. In the long term, I guess this is worthwhile to do all this. A.getColor. He's compensating. Draw edge. A dot. Man, I hope everything still works when I run this eventually. I kind of dove right into the deep end on this one without even taking a breath. A dot, A dot, A dot, A dot, A dot, A dot. There needs to be a lady Bafu. Lady Fu. Wait, there's gotta be a better name than just Lady Fu. Help a wizard out. What should Bafu's female version be called? This is all Boogie. Boogie knows. Boogie already's got this in mind. He's like, I've already wrote that. Okay, whew, got through that function. There is, but she never appears on the stream. Yeah. Miss Fu? Miss Fu's pretty good. Miss Fu. I like it, Bunny. Miss Fu. Miss Fit Fu? Miss Fit Fu. Oh, how many more functions do I gotta freaking refactor here? Little bunny foo foo. Mage foo. Mage foo, sorceress foo. Witch foo, witch foo. Which witch are you talking about, man? Ay, ay, ay. Which foo? That foo. How about F you, foo? Foo. That's just like foo foo, though. Fatali foo. Foo foo. Fru foo. It's pretty good. Fubu. We're getting early thousands. That's right. We remember. World got data. I'm gonna get some data. Get the ground from the data. It's foo. That works. That was founded in 92. Call equals data get color. What's up, Pippa Torino? What am I doing right now? Well, let me tell you what my goal is right now. My goal is this. I'm working on this area of the Songbringer ship where it will be the bridge. There'll be a captain. There'll be a captain's chair, some other chairs, some blinking lights and console-y stuff and windows. It'll look out on the sky. But right now, so I need to code something. So basically this big old ground texture that's on the floor, this is one big ground texture. This whole thing could be chopped up so that there's some sky on the outside. So I'm kind of stuck right now. Well, I'm not stuck, but I'm just like, I'm in the middle of this crazy refactor. I was like, oh, I should move these into, make these static functions. And then I didn't realize how deep that would go. So I'm like refactoring right now. So soon I should be finished and be back to that point where I'm actually doing what I said I was going to do. But it's going to take a minute. Awesome. Windows. What about it? Yeah. Oh, like Windows. Windows, right? Yeah. There's gonna be Windows. Kirk or Picard? Ooh. Ooh. What? Did we just go there? What am I gonna vote? What am I gonna say here? Kirk or Picard? I mean, Kirk's the original, but Picard, Janeway. I like, wait. Is it new? Are we talking about old Kirk or new Kirk? Songbringer ship runs Windows. Good joke, buddy. Good joke. I like that. A dot get color, A dot get color, A dot get color, A dot, A dot, A dot, A dot. Well, in order to run the game, I need to finish this freaking refactor. You know what? I love New Kirk. It runs on OS 2. What about BIOS? Do you guys remember BIOS? The thing that the OS that never really was. I was so excited about BIOS, and then it just never really came about. Or did it? Did it ever come about? I don't remember. It doesn't look as cool as I remember it. I can't zoom in. There's gotta be a better screenshot of BIOS. OS 2 Warp actually still lives on? Really? It's sold today? No way. This is a great example right here. BIOS doesn't look as cool as I remember at all. Yeah, they went out of business. Is it that Biatch died? Really? React? React OS. Reactos. Reactos. This is Windows, isn't it? Really? This is Linux? This is Linux, but it looks exactly like Windows 95. BIOS. Don't tell me somebody actually named their OS BIOS. It's not Linux? Oh, really? It's an open source re-implementation of Windows? See, there's no actual BIOS OS. Is there? '98, yeah, man, '98, '95, '98, Windows Me. That episode of the IT Crowd where they're trying to defuse the bomb, but it's an OS running Windows. Or what Windows version was it? Was it me? We don't talk about Windows Me. Oh, really? There was an actual Microchef Windows? I didn't know that. Oh, it was made. Remember that? Remember Macromedia Director? You remember loading bars? Rocket Bunny doesn't remember loading bars. There haven't been loading bars. Remember when games used to have loading bars? Loading. Dot, dot, dot. Hypercard? Oh, what was Hypercard again? I remember this, but I don't remember this. Hypercard, what was that? Mist. Oh yeah, programming tool, that's right. Among the first successful hypermedia systems before the World Wide Web. Haha. You don't know much about what we're saying. Oh, Rocket Bunny. I know you were, man. You were. Yeah, right. Programmers these days are lazy. They only want to go to 99. Jeez, I'm getting with the times. I'm lazy. I'm lazy, man. Starting to get lazy. Like, why am I doing this? Why am I doing this refactor here? This really isn't that making that much of a difference. Moved a couple functions from a header file into just a CPP file. Makes a slight difference. A very, very slight difference. No difference to the player. Very focused. Oh, yeah, yeah, that way. Isn't it boring programming for a long time? Sometimes it is. It is when you're doing stuff like this, just you're just refactoring, and it's not like there's much reward out of it. God, man, I'm starting to regret even taking this little jaunt into refactor land. I was like, oh, this will just take a second. I just need to move these from the header right here into the... But then I forgot how to change all this in response to changing that. It can be very meditative. That's right. It can, huh? It's right. It's kind of brainless coding. I'm not really thinking. I could turn off my mind. Turn off your mind, Luke. Use the force, Luke. Like this, a dot delete entity. Wait, wait. Yeah, okay. A dot delete entity. Id after delay plus duration. Sometimes you just gotta delete the game and start over. Rewriting the game from scratch. You tune in? Oh, thanks. Glad I got you guys' support in this. Should I just... How many lines of code would I be throwing away if I started over? Not that I ever would do such a thing. Oh my god, it's like... Freaks me out even thinking about it. But 74,000... lines of code. At least 5,000 of those lines are unnecessary, I'm telling you. Poor Songbringer to DOS. It's fun to watch, but you don't know why? Cool. I'm glad it's fun to watch. Okay, now we can call Great Ground Tile. Hey. Oh my god, I already had a count function. Does that do the exact same thing as the other count function I just wrote? Oh no, this actually goes and counts. Alright, alright. Okay, different thing. RM.RF. Oh man, that, when I first, this is so funny, when I first encountered a computer was at my grandpa and grandma's house. I think I was 7 years old, and I was instantly fascinated by it. It had a green screen, you know, like, I mean, you know what I mean? Like the black screen, but the letters were all green. This was back then. This is before the 286. I think this is before even the first 86, whatever that was. Anyways, I picked up the manual, flipped to the first command I found, and decided to try it. I'm like, well, if I'm going to learn how to use this computer, I might as well try some commands. The first command was format. I typed in format A colon, just like the example, and I erased my game that I was playing. I had some game on the A disc. I was like, yeah, I can't wait to play this game. I just erased it, the first command I ever entered. Jadeworks HyperCard. Check it. Totally 95. Yeah, look at that. Look at that image. It's like, looks like Maniac Mansion. At least do Sound Blaster. Yes. Sound Blaster. Man, I actually wrote games in DOS. That was hard. You had to write your own timer by interrupting. You had to interrupt the freaking... What interrupt was it? I don't remember. Some interrupt where you had to interrupt it just to be able to get the time. Are you sure you want to format A? Yes! Do it! I want to learn this! Do I? Yeah! True story. You wrote a snake game back in the late 80s? Cool. What language? Oh, the Write Protect tab. I learned about that later. That came later on. That was one of those moments where I'm like, oh, that's what this thing does? It's a Write Protect? This is before that, though. This is the 5 1/4 inch floppies, which I don't think they 5 1/4 had the Write Protect, did they? I don't think they did. Maybe I'm remembering wrong. Why else would I be typing this command? 5 1/2. Oh, you had to tape it or punch it out, so it did have those. Oh, it did? It was just one of those things you didn't even want to use it because you're like, really? I have to put a piece of tape on that? I have to MacGyver my own disc? Double-sided, remember that? Double-sided. What a fun trip down memory lane this has been today. Talking about things Rockin' Bunny doesn't know anything about. Sorry, Bunny. Oh, wait, no, this is not A dot positions, it's just positions. This is A dot width, A dot width, A dot get color mix, high density disks. Yeah. Oh, Bunny. Poor Bunny. Suffice it to say, Bunny, we had old, slow computers. They were much more limited than today's computers, but they were still just as awesome. Maybe they were more awesome than I'm remembering, or less awesome, one of those. Stickers, they did. Oh, it was stickers. What's an assert and what's a static assert? Well, in general, an assertion is just checking something, but it's usually in debug mode, right? You're like asserting a fact. You're asserting a fact. Asserting something is like, I want to assert, which means like guarantee. I want to guarantee that this is always like that. Or not guarantee, but more like, that's a good word for it. Yeah, Apple IIs. I'm cooking. Intentionally crash unless this condition is true. Pretty much. A dot. Am I getting close? I think I'm getting close. Finally, there's only 10 errors. Whew, jeez. Finally, we can get on like with the point of what I, the point of this stream, to make the bridge. This is a private member. It's no longer a private member. Get evenly spaced position. What is a static assert? Is that a thing? Oh, assertions at compile time. You could put a static assert like this. Really? Is that a thing, huh? Static assert? You're bridging the past and the present. Good point. There is a CPP static assert. Wow, I didn't even know that. Basically, you generate a compiler error if you, based on whatever assertion you're making. A dot. Static ass. Pound define static assert static ass. Auto color, get color. Gotta go faster. Gotta go fast. Sonic. Gotta go fast. Crazy fast. Ludicrous fast. Faster. Nice, bunny. All right, create grass, create plant. Why are these? I guess we'll put these back. Keep my code. Easy, watch this. Area ref, area ref. Area dot area pause. Area dot flags. Esoteric cases. Other way around, bunny. Other way around. Swap it. Screw this part. Create grass, we're putting it back. Create grass, create plant. You can go back. I don't want to change that. Tired of refactoring. Nobody should be. Oh, do we have no errors? Tell me we have no errors. Oh, 7 errors. Redefine if? I already did that once. Remember, it just broke. The compiler didn't compile. It was like, sorry. Error. Compiler error. Create names. Can I just put that one back? Create NPCs. Create items. Jeez, yeah, I'm putting these back. I don't want to redefine anything more. Items, names, and NPCs are all going back. I'm tired of this. What time do macros run? Come on, tell me you know the answer to this one. Come on, Rocket Bunny. What do you think? What do you think? Don't anybody tell him the answer now. Oh, dang. Create items, create names, create NPCs. Stay here. Hopefully there's no errors this time, and we can just proceed with the freaking the method. Just all I want to do is I'm going to take this big image here. I'm going to slice it up into a bunch of different tiles. Every one of the tiles that has some ground will get this, a slice of the image. It'll just take it, this, everything, every single one of these will be, or start off with the entire texture, and then we'll use a small texture rect slice of the image. So. Yeah. Still more. Ada area plus. Ada gets out plus. Area block size. What's ironic is I think I put pixel art as one of the tags for today's stream. Not, it's a lie. There was no pixel art today. There was gonna be. Hey. How's that for irony? Please be the last function. Please be the last function. Oh, we're so close. Get plant colors, private method. Aha, okay, so this is gonna become in direction of it second, but passing in this. Get plant color. Why is that private? Why was that ever private? I think there's a couple other, oh, here we go. Color mix, close enough. No whammies, no whammies. That seriously, yeah, that seriously ate up the pretty much the whole stream. Sorry, guys. Man. Man, oh, man. Well, maybe that was valuable on some people programming out there. Here's the point of all that. If you were watching that, if anyone was paying attention there, what I was doing there was moving things out of a header and into just the source file so that other files that include the header don't necessarily need to process those particular functions. It makes the compiler slightly faster. This has no effect on the actual game, unless I introduce a bug. It's necessary, right? Yeah. Yeah, you're going to eventually have to refactor stuff. Well, that's what I was doing right there, refactoring. So for anybody out there learning programming and stuff, I was refactoring some code to make it a little better. Responsible programming, that's a good name for it. Oh yeah, right, exactly. Totally necessary in your case right there. Okay, look at this. So now we're missing the ground. Ground is gone. Shouldn't be too bad to put it back though. Is there any ground down here? There's no ground here either. Might be these are. Start here. Does it find the ground funk? Avoid at all costs unless you absolutely must. I don't know. I wish I could just write code the right way the first time, every time. But a lot of times you don't necessarily have the design of the entire system right in your mind when you first start it. It takes a while until the system becomes mature, and then you realize, oh, I should have done this system a little bit more like that. And then you refactor. So, okay, does it find this ground funk? What is the ground style? Ground style for this area is image one. That sounds right. It found it. Very good. But it ran image two ground. Well, now it's starting to make sense. Why would it have image style? Wait. Oh, here we go. Here's why. Okay. Bug fix number one. Oh, premature refactoring? Yeah. There definitely is, huh? When you don't really know, you don't really have that that bird's eye view of your system. Yay! You guys got sound? La 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 la. Okay, funny thing, I did just realize that there's Sky One and Fog One backgrounds where we don't even need them. There's no game sound? Damn, that means I would have to restart game show. Well, we're just gonna have to deal with having no sound in the game for the last few minutes of today's stream. You know what, I'm gonna keep going until I can figure out this thing. Narcos, here's what I'm working on. I'm working on this, this is an area of Songbringer, the ship, where it's the bridge, where there's a captain's chair and windows and stuff. So out here, you're gonna be looking at the sky. And this is what I'm working on right now, is taking this ground texture, slicing it up into little bits so that part of it can draw, part of it doesn't need to draw. So this function, choose styles, this chooses a background style. The ship has background none by default. If area pause dot z equals k ship z, or constants get level z. Microsoft sponsored, confirmed. Here we go again. Starting over. A pause z equals k world num max num levels. No, wait, no, this should be if area style. No, style car. Style car equals 8. BG style equals equals K background. Oh man, see? This is what happens when you refactor too much. You can't even code straight. Can't even code straight right now. So there, we have no background. And since this area we're starting at has image 2 style, or should, we should have nothing on the ground. Oh, we're in the wrong area. All right. We gotta go back to, where was that? 0, 1, negative 2. Good, 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 good. Okay, so we've got a totally black background. There's no ground here, but there should be some ground here. Yeah, okay, cool. We got ground here, no ground here. So now we need to put in the ground tiles, but make them so they're sliced up. And then we'll put in the background out here where it's all purple or pink or blue sky and some clouds and stuff. Okay, so choose, or I mean, wait, no, this is the wrong file. Area, here we go. Area.cpp, image 2 ground. I know all that to take out the ground. All that. 2 hours. Jeez. Yeah, I agree with muteness. Avoid refactoring. If you don't have to refactor, why? Don't fix it if it ain't broke. All right, so we can get the image. We've got stir ground.image. If stir.empty, we can return. Okay, so now we're going to loop over all tiles for each X, Y. For each entity, I think I already did this actually. I might have a... Yeah, here it is. I created an entity. Get its render component, change its background. This is, in essence, what's going to happen here. A.entities that push back, create an entity, put it at position pause, which is. Auto pause equals A dot get tile pause based on X, Y. Now we got a position render component. Could just do render component based on the frame. So we'll go auto frame equals. VS didn't install correctly. Oh, I know. Yes, I had to repair Visual Studio like every day for an entire week, and it never worked. And finally, I just went back on an old backup of the entire hard drive. I'm like, I'm just gonna swipe Windows and go backwards. There's nothing fixed it. Nothing fixed Visual Studio. It was that broken. It was so broken. Feel for me. Get sprite frame. I think it's called kit get sprite frame. Is it that's what this is it, right? Get sprite frame? Yes. No, that's not what I'm talking about. Get sprite frame by name. Stir. If frame equals null pointer. Return. So now we can initialize the render component with the frame. Set it to really low. Use a color. What color? Just white. Okay, this should be working so far. It takes 3 weeks. Oh, thank you. Thank you for that kitty cat slash raccoon. A.enemies back. Okay, so now we created this entity based on that entire texture. Now we're gonna slice it up by using a different texture rect. Sprite. No, we're gonna create a sprite. I'm just using the sprite we already have. Rect equals render.sprite.getTextureRect. Raccoon! Yeah, I said raccoon. Area. Okay, so the rect origin is block size.x. Height minus y minus 1 times block size dot y. Rect dot size is block size. Sprite set texture rect. Okay, if this works, we will have part of the screen using those textures and part of the screen using black sky. Yeah. Undefined A dot height, what are you talking about? Yeah. I was wondering too. I thought you were talking about some Microsoft Bing service, but then I realized you were saying binge. Come on, work. Come on, yeah. No, it didn't work. Son of a bitch. Why didn't it work? How about if I don't do this loop at all? Huh? What happens then? Still got blackness, right? Right, okay, so it's not using the right pause. Okay, let's check this out step by step. We'll get the rect, see what it's doing to the rect, see how it's applying the rect. Abhorrence and Veil still dominating. 15,000 points. Abhorrence and Veil, show yourself. Muteness in third was 6,000 points. Whoa. Origin size. Origin size. The size should be pretty small. Should become 20 by 12. Oh. I see what's going on here. If it's a sky tile, we're skipping it, man. That's all we gotta do. If blocks is A dot area pause X Y K tile sky return. Return faster, no, not return. Don't return. Do not return. Continue. Spider crawling animation outline? Yes, it worked. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. So this blackness out here is where the sky is gonna be. Yeah. Let's do it right now. Okay. So when we choose styles, once again, there's a special case. Pattern ship bridge. Ground style is that, and then VG style. Okay, background. Sky one, sky two, one of these. We'll use one of these for now. Eventually, it'll make this better. See, those 2 hours weren't for nothing. They kind of were for nothing. Damien Ford, this is a program called Xcode, it's free. I also use Visual Studio on Windows, and I use GCC on Mac and just Vim. Yay! Okay, that looks weird because we haven't implemented any ground right here or any walls or any windows or anything. But this is kind of the thing, right? You're on the ship's bridge, there'll be a captain's chair right here. There'll be some consoles right here and here. It'll look just like your standard spaceship. And then there'll be windows and stuff, so it'll look right. And the sky will be brighter. And there'll be a new NPC dude right here, the captain. Hacker confirmed. All right, so that's it for today's stream. I'm glad this actually got accomplished. I felt like I was in refactor land for a hell of a long time, and in fact, I was. Most of the stream was just refactoring something, which wasn't entirely necessary. Not an entirely necessary refactor, but oh well. It was sort of worth it. So I'm going to take a break, get some dinner, and then it looks like you're hovering over London. Right? Yeah. Yep. And then after the break, I'll continue working on this. Put in some walls, some windows, some other stuff. So thanks a lot for watching, everybody. It was fun chatting about all the stuff we chatted on. Hang on. What are we hanging on? Oh, you're talking about to Rocker Bunny? All right. Cool, guys. So, yep. We'll see y'all next time. I'm actually not going to be here tomorrow or the next day because I got appointments. I got an appointment tomorrow afternoon and the next afternoon. Actually, the next afternoon, I got a podcast. So I'll be on a podcast with some dudes called the Game Over Podcast. You check it out. Just search for Game Over Podcast on Google. They're funny. So, see you guys. Laters.